Do you even know who the fuck I am? Do ya? Oh, what is up, guys? You're here for week four. At Eldora. It is concluded now. We do have a guest today. Instead of kind of performing just a little interview with someone, we have at least a temporary co-host, which was heavily requested, but we have none other than the inaugural winner at Eldora in the Pro Series. So why not have him on this week? No one better than Adam, and your nickname will be The Eater, because you get fed a lot.
Adam the Eater.
Adam the Eater Albie on the show with us. And you have Tom in the background, too, sometimes.
Screams at the TV, but that's nothing new.
It's nothing new. But, so we're just taking a look at the points again real quick. Not many changes. A lot of guys in the top 10 finished top 10. Just looking at the cutoff, we have J.D. Brown snuck in there. So, what do you think about that? You think here? Oh, you're 17th in points. You're not requalifying.
Yep. Mm. Nope. Not as of now.
So who do you think? So who do you think you can knock out of there in points? Do you think? Huh? You can get by J.D. Probably Colton.
See, it's not like how my season's been. It's not even really based off of performance. Really, it's just about luck and. Mm. Not getting wrecked is really what it comes down to. I mean, any of those guys really can finish up in the top 10 of any race, but it's just if they can finish in the top 10 of any race. But I'd say anybody, you know, from 8th on back is, you know, people I'd definitely group myself with. 7 up is, I think they're all kind of on another level, you know, back when how I used to be back in my inaugural winning days. No longer is the case.
Yeah, and one person you don't have to worry about passing you back in points is Dylan Semmelman, because he is out of here! He gone! Banhammer struck for reasons unknown, but we like to conspiracize here. There was talk in the server of cheating, and that was put to an end really quick. Are they trying to cover up something? Are there cheats on dirt? I'm not going to confirm. I'm not going to deny. But I will sell them to you if you have the right price. Anywho.
I'm not involved with that.
Adam Albee is not involved with this.
I'm a hostage.
Cheegan is no joke on iRacing. So it was account sharing. Oh. And so speculation is still out on that. But that brings the grand total to the over-under on suspensions in the series. I don't remember what it was. I think it was maybe 3.5. That is our first. Dylan Semmelman's gone. Now,
who do you think is next to get suspended, if anyone? Well, I feel like we have a lot of good behavior people this year.
We do, but we also have two people on in incidents on a 12X. So, here we look at the incident. You know, this doesn't have anything to do with the running totals, but surprisingly, Cameron Merriman is the top by 12 incidents so far, almost halfway in the year. I don't think that's something anyone saw coming.
Yeah, he's actually a fairly clean driver. I don't see him get into. I can't think of one time where he's actually.
No, and I don't think he has any 4Xs for like an actual wreck. So, it kind of shows the difference from these incident points versus the other incident points that we're talking about, like in like the captain the championship. Fucking Logan keeps calling me. But I think we have Cole and Sheeble are on 12X, and we'll get into that why. So we kind of hop in the server now. Look at that qualifying. Tim Ryan, quick time. Track reset again to 1%. Adam, what do you think about the tracks refreshing, resetting before qualifying?
I am all for the resets as long as the drivers don't know what it is beforehand. But we get our drivers meeting emails around noon, somewhere around there every day, the day of, and then from there on, it's just no life that, and that's, I don't know, I think it takes a lot of the fun out of it.
Oh, fuck,
I've been qualifying better this year than I have any other year. I think last year I never broke the top 15, and this year I've been in the top 10 every single time, other than this week I was absolutely terrible. But
well, so you say as long as it's a surprise to the drivers, what do you think the percentages should maybe be? Because so far we have 3%, 5%, 5%, and 1%. So it's like they're just picking numbers out of a hat. How big would your happy? Yeah. Would you say 40% are we set to? No, because then the racing would be iffy. So what really...
I would say anywhere between 1% and 5%, and if it's any more than that, run it in practice and run on that state. Because any higher than 5% is just going to make for bad racing the rest of the night, because you get that slick spot that is ice the rest of the night.
Okay, unfortunately,
as long as we don't know, then I don't care. But when we all know, you know, it just kind of takes the fun out of qualifying. And, I mean, look, I qualified, I think, 22nd. And I was 300ths off of probably 8th place, maybe.
I'm not able to look at all the qualifying laps because this isn't my replay. And unfortunately dropped out of the server, so yeah. Well, look,
if I go 300ths quicker, then I'm...
I would argue that, well, if you want the randomness, you just give people time on track, and, you know, it's like it's almost up to the drivers on how the track is worn in, and there's your randomness.
Yeah, I mean, we've been getting the full 20 minutes of practice, and not everybody's going out there and using all of it. Me, myself,
no,
I've been
not at all.
Just doing tons of laps, gaining that safety rating.
Yeah, people just went SR in practice now.
So that's what I did. Mm-hmm. But... I mean, people are going to want to save the track, naturally, because you don't want something blown off, and then maybe reset it fresh for warm-up, and then have people do the same thing, you know?
Yeah. Have you liked it carrying over all whole night so far? Have you liked the feature tracks?
I think they've been okay. They've been good. Eldora, as we'll see, you know, just goes top dominant, but it was still looked like a good race, but we'll watch that later. But the rest of the tracks seem like they haven't been too bad. Fairbury's on the top. It is what it's going to be. Knoxville was good until my middle went away. That was trash.
Let's talk about this. I don't know if Brett gets a... Oh, he can go on. Not sure what Alex Smulders was doing here, because he was fucking... It's like he got Brett a black flag intentionally. If I was Brett, I would keep up pretty pissed, but he was blinking out this whole time.
I'm going to look and see if he got an incident for that, because I don't know for sure, honestly.
I have it right here. Brett or Alex?
Brett.
Neither.
Brett
no.
got an incident. The...
No.
No, I mean in the incident report.
No. Didn't.
I'm surprised he didn't for jumping the start.
How could he jump the start? The guy in front of him didn't go and went high.
You're not supposed to be in front of the car, in front of you.
Okay.
Hey, all right.
We're so-called the best of the best drivers. We have a 2-car length gap from the guy in front of us, and then they go, and you clearly see. What's Brett supposed to do?
In the rule book for the Pro Series, you are supposed to stay nose to tail till the finish line. But I don't think that's Brett's fault. I think it was a bad move on Smulders. So
you're just essentially saying you would penalize Brett for this.
No, I'm saying I actually agree with how they did not penalize Brett for this, as it wasn't really his fault. It was, and who knows what Smulders was doing there, but I'm just surprised he didn't get one, is what I'm saying.
Hmm. Well, he ends up finishing sixth, so maybe there was just a time penalty? No, because he was close to JD, and JD finished fifth for sure, but...
It'd probably at least be a 1-second time penalty, and there's no way he was 2/10 off of the leader.
No, exactly. So I guess he didn't get a black at all. That's really interesting.
I like how they left it up to the game. I mean, for that incident right there, you know, I don't think Brett should have to lift and potentially cause a wreck. So he just
exactly
so
he if he lifts,
shoulders.
He gets ran over. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. If he got a black, which it looks like he should have. That's why he didn't key up, I guess, though, because he didn't get a black, but I would have been losing my shit.
Right.
That's just me. I'm a fucking...
No live admins!
So, everything was pretty much follow the train. Real tight slagger here. That's about all you can do here.
Yeah.
We knew the bottom of 1 and 2 was probably going to go away on the flat part in the first heat, and Kendall kind of gets that right here. Gets a good run. throws it, comes up, and now there's
nice run down the hill.
Yep, there's the first instance of like netcode that, well, even though it's not like, you know, like a gap netcode of a foot that you normally see, but you know, Tim just running over his tire like that the whole night, even in the practice servers leading up, so it wasn't like a pro race specific thing, right? It just seemed like the netcode was really bad between everyone.
Right, and in that case, it saved Tim, honestly, with his Aussie connection. Yeah. I think Tim was gonna do what he wanted to do regardless. He didn't have any netcode in mind or what was gonna happen. He was gonna try and squeeze down Kendall there as much as possible.
Yeah.
And I mean, that's what he did, and somehow got away with it. I mean, just luck, honestly.
Yeah, and that was, like I said, the first incident of many netcodes we'll see in the night. Don't think anything happens in the back.
What really was just Smolders doing on that start?
Don't know.
Unless it wasn't Smolders.
And then so yeah, not much there to be said after that. Everyone pretty much finished where they started. Heat 2. Oh, hey, we find a guy. All right. All right, so we are starting in 6th. We'll go on board with you. So what are we thinking at the start? Are we thinking get a transfer spot? Are we thinking survive turn 1? Are we thinking get one car?
I'm thinking, I know the line's only going to move up from here. Okay. I can keep the guys on my inside. They're going to have no speed. I'll drive around them. I think I got a really good start here. It looks a lot closer than that in VR. But right here, see, I don't know how thanks for that.
So we'll look at so you got a 4x for this? Okay.
Yeah, that was an incident. I can't tell if he got loose or if I netcoded him. Spin this around?
Trying to spin. Hello. Why can't I spin?
Spin.
I can only go forward and backwards.
Click Y or
we could try this.
Give us an aerial view, yeah.
maybe we can.
That doesn't make it look as good as I would like.
No.
And then change your FOV and zoom it in. Oh, that was.
Hang on, I was gonna slow us down and this definitely looks like some netcode, but it almost his car just reacted weird to it. I'm not gonna get the real far chase back.
Donkey, even try and appeal that, nuts. Or just leave it?
Well, what'd that end up causing? That's
a 4x for me, and then he gets a 4x for that.
Gotcha.
I don't get. He lifts there and then gets back on the gas afterwards and drove through me. I mean, we all could have drove away from that.
Yeah, it just started with weird contact, and then
I tap the back of the guy, right, netcode or not, I lift because I see him getting loose, and then
alright, this is some good far chase at least. But yeah, just looking at your cockpit view again, it was I would have just
loose once. I don't know if he
did he break loose in that slick though?
I find that hard to believe that a pro got loose like that. I don't know if there would...
No, it's just he came in straight and then made a hard turn. And then you were kind of still coming up straighter. You didn't turn as hard, essentially.
Unfortunate that we could all drive away from that. This happened.
Yeah.
I got heated.
Yeah.
Look, don't give up because we gained 2 positions.
Oh, did we? Okay. Well, they start battling. Fuck, this camera's gonna annoy the shit out of me.
So we could watch a race. Enough about me on that one. We'll have plenty of me to talk about later.
Slider by Mayer. When you're in this position, especially in 3 and 4 like here, you gotta be... He should have cut down, like, right here. Just cuts down too late. He could have cut down to some good grip here, maybe. Just gave himself a little better one. Yeah. And then he could get through a shorter slider into 1 and 2, but you have to kind of throw up a big one. I like the undercut here.
Good move.
Wasn't going to clear himself high, though. Black Lives Matter. Front, there's more contact that happens here. Oh! There's probably a little more net code. Let's see if we can get. Oh, watch this. Watch this. Isn't there a bumper cam?
That David Heilman YouTube sponsored car?
No, no affiliation with the 500 subscriber one. There's contact. And then you see Lewis Car High here. Now, he never got an X for this. He never got an X for any of this. And I mean, after the race, but during the race too. He didn't get an
Right.
incident for the wall, for the car, for the flipping. He had a 0 X from that. And this is what I mean, where like the servers were so bad because he said he didn't think Shea was anywhere near him. You can almost throw it as the second wreck of this heat race, maybe contributed to that. How much? But yeah, he said he didn't have any kind of an incident. we're battling just for his fifth spot. Two to go. Ryan trying to bring that bottom back in a little bit. Gave it up. Fall back in line. All he can do. He should have been building up ahead of steam here. He shouldn't have gone bottom right there. He wasn't going to clear him. Wasn't going to be able to do anything with Job. All he did was hurt his next one and two, and ultimately never able to do anything back there. Yeah, should have just stayed high and built up the momentum more. Heat three. This one got pretty hectic. It's got some high-profile guys in it, and but this is kind of where the first heat where the track really opened up to some good racing. Bragan throws it back in one and two. Colton kind of prematurely cuts down. Cole just got into the wall by himself there. That kind of starts everything. Made contact with Bragan. Mason sliding up. Zoom in. Looks like that middle came back a little now.
This is when the turn down starts getting good. You're
Yep, there
losing
you
grip
see
off of
Cam do
exit
it
of
down
two, so
there.
you get the speed from the top of one and then carry it down to bottom of two. If you try and stay high, it just spins the tires. Then you could also take that to the slider line of three and four. Smart move by Cole there,
Yeah, nice job
watching
by
his
Cole,
mirror.
knowing to. Not that's even his mirror. If you're in VR, I'm sure you saw this. Let's see what this looks like from
He
him.
doesn't
So he
run
just
VR.
started cutting down and. Oh, did he? That's right. He has it, but he stopped using it. Yeah,
Yeah,
really
he
good
sold it
reflex there
after a
by
week,
turning
but
out.
yeah.
Oh.
Oh! Dustin Griffith's throwing some left rears. Did he just get loose off of the wall? Because I know that cushion gets pretty. Or did he. He
He was
kind of
just
turned
turning
down,
down
but.
from Bragan, and yeah, no clue
Yeah,
that
he's just
Mason.
avoiding. I mean, it's kind of a
Honestly,
racing deal.
yeah, it's a racing deal, but Mason shouldn't put himself in that spot. Like, if we just look at the corner he ran here, he just runs bottom to middle, and you know the middle's gonna have no drive off.
Right.
And it
Don't
kind
crowd
of
cars
it
when you
was
have to.
yeah, it was kind of susceptible to that. Gets run out too, keeping it up, keeping the momentum going. Like I said, this is something that probably Ryan should have did last race. Not sure about the cut down there,
Sheesh.
especially just because of that, because you know that car
Yeah.
is low.
He hesitated going underneath him. He definitely could have took the underneath
Could have done
and.
middle, yeah, middle or high, and then maybe Dustin saw him coming and thought he was going to shoot middle
Right.
and tried to hold it lower, and then he had to yank the wheel further left. Let's see if he does it again. Yeah, so he thinks it's fast, but there, yeah, there he kind of got squeezed up off it. Like, I think if he ran the top there, he would have been able to keep a little more speed. Thought he hit the wall here because I thought he crashes later. Maybe Dustin just nuts the bottom here. Oh, he ran the cut down again. So yeah, he ran the cut down, and this time Dustin just came up. Don't know, especially after the first time where he had to turn under that, I would have stopped doing that. I know I always say carry as much momentum as you can into the last corner, and cut down would have been that, but he should have never turned off. He had no reason to turn off the wall and follow Cole there. Especially because, like, he beat Dustin out of two this lap, the lap before.
At the same time there, as soon as you see that car and you don't think that you're gonna be able to turn underneath them, if you lift for a split second, you buy your time to, you still have your momentum. You have more momentum than them. You can lift, give yourself more time for him to slide up
It's
as
crazy
you're coming
talk.
down the
That's crazy
hill, and
talk.
then you can play
I'm
him on
not
the
lifting out
inside.
of two. I'm not lifting out of two in a heat race on the last lap. But yeah,
He
ultimately
still
not
has that.
lifting
He still
him.
has.
I'm
He
not
lifts
lifting
for a
him, putting him in
second.
that situation instead of finishing even fifth there in pole of the main. He finishes seventh. So no, I know what you mean. It's kind of like,
He still has more miles per hour down the straightaway, and he buys himself
yeah,
more time to
cause
clear
Dustin's
himself coming
still
down.
sliding up through the middle, doesn't have
Right.
all the drive. Here we have, okay, we're gonna specialize on the eight car a little this race. A little slagger action for the league, cross or for second. Oh shit, I wasn't looking. Alright, well, Sheeble just cuts down here. Doesn't really have anywhere to go with his momentum. I mean, he could have just went higher, but I guess he was just aiming for that grip off and kind of tunnel vision that grip. Ran right in the back of Lamy. That kind of starts this slide job battle here. Call there. Clears himself up. Not bad by throwing it back by Cole. Cut down. Should have been slagging up more. If Sheeple gets up to the crumbs there, carries a ton more
Yeah, he
momentum.
definitely could be sending it harder. That was a good turn down. He's on the
I
back
think
foot a
we
little bit, but
over-rotated a little much. To do that, like, he didn't have to run that big of a turn down. See what he does here.
right.
That one was better. It was a little more clean. Still didn't really get the momentum. And here we have it. So actually, let's go back and watch the last lap.
That turn down he did right there with not this one, but the next lap. With Rumsey that close to him is very risky.
Oh yeah. So here you
You
see
lose so
how
much.
deep he throws this slider in, where he's on the wall, this low and everything. And Cole is at the wall here. So we come to the next lap. Same thing, runs the cut down, but this time he's two car lanes higher, and he's like just cutting down on entrance or yeah, because even if he was running the middle right here, there'd be no reason to run the middle for Cole. Like, this is always my biggest thing with when why wrecks, like, because most of the time when I at least make contact with people, it's because they run a line that I don't expect them to. And so I
Right.
said, what, like, it's for me, what is this line? Last lap, he ran the top all the way, that's fine. Here, he just runs cut down, but he's not cutting to the bottom at all either because he knows Sheeble's there. But if he's just running it to the middle, like, there's no grip on exit of four.
It's
Like, you're
almost
gonna.
like they're trying to
Yeah.
play a mind game
It,
more than
yeah.
anything, it seems
Yeah.
like.
Maybe if
And
he
then
was
just
trying to chop him, he's gotta be down the straightaway more. He's gotta be chopping him here, not here. And so, I mean, it's just they both differed lines by two car widths.
And you gotta think too, when you're on somebody's outside, out past the right front, I mean, we have these big sailboards on the right side of the car. You can't really see out past that. You kind of have to
Yeah,
take that
like
into
if we watch.
consideration when you're
Yeah.
changing your line. Like if you
I
if
bet you don't even see
so
Cole
if
here.
Cole if Cole is to Yeah, no, you don't see him. If Cole is to run the middle, he honestly enters like sh he honestly enter should have entered like Schiebel did with that straight speed into the
Yes,
corner.
it was a
To clear
bad line
himself.
by him. And Sheeble
But
didn't see him at all.
Cole, right, but Cole entered higher and came down. He should have expected that. Where if you take Schiebel's line and just place
If
it where
Cole would have
Cole
ran the
is,
top, he would have probably
right.
fell in line right behind Cole on the exit of corner. But Cole didn't do that. Ultimately, it's a racing deal because they both changed their lines. But it's just how Cole could have avoided it and really Sheeple. If sure Sheeple could get through a deeper slider, a deep slider like he did the lap before. But lucky it didn't completely destroy his car, but I don't think it got him any positions later. We have Logan. Yeah, Batista was fast again, but just one of those guys who can't really shoot himself in the foot in qualifying, really. Because this would have been probably his best track. What the fuck is his name? I guess he qualified to 20-something outside the top 20.
I feel like qualifying was so much bigger last year. I don't know why it just seems different this year. Maybe it's just how my season has been going, but it seems like it. I don't know if these tracks, since they're not as used up, different lines come in quicker, and we actually have track to use, where last year everything was so used up, it's almost like everybody's the same speed. It's already too slow to. You're not gonna find that one line that'll get you a tenth faster than everybody else, like it is kind of now.
Yeah,
So it
I could
seems
see
like
that.
qualifying this year isn't as big because, there's more.
Even though the track's
The bigger the.
tackier and faster, the grip is that much more important where you can.
Right. Finding the line first is what's more important, really.
Yes. So it's not like where in last year you some of the heats the one guy will find the bottom and then everyone will move to that, but that line will be just so much faster. Where this one or two different lines might be fast at the same time. Is that kind of.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah, because I could say I remember a lot of. Like, I'm thinking of, like, Lernerville last year. When the heat races are pretty used up. Like,
I
one
mean,
was all bottom, the next
you
one was all
sacrifice.
top, and the next one was, like, all middle.
Right. You sacrifice your first heat race to be a train, but it makes for the rest of the racing pretty well, and then your consies aren't absolutely used up either. Like, this is honestly a perfect B main track right here.
Yeah. Did he give you guys 60 minutes of warm up or 90 seconds?
I don't know. I didn't make
Oh.
the.
All right. So, oh, Cam almost got the inside wall there. Good job not sliding all the way up to the slick. Brett's trying to rip there. Oh,
Oh.
contact, contact.
He's
Okay. I
Hannigan not having a
think
great year.
Mason got this. He was top like 20 in points. They gave this to Stigham. Really?
Does he hold? Does Stidham hold his line there? It kind of looks like he does. Oh.
Says turn four, lap four.
He kind of goes low to avoid
He has
Rusty
to
there. He's
stay
forced
low.
down though.
Yeah. If I'm
And
him,
then.
I'm probably because Mason starts coming down more than he's coming up, I think. Where
Yeah.
like I said, it's just another thing where if Mason stays high, it doesn't. Jesus. Did you see him hang on the wall? Bringing him back here, just not able to make anything work. He is our low-cow underachiever of the week this week. Even I guess, well, I brought him on the show last week, so maybe that's a jinx. Sorry, Adam, if you don't make next race's feature.
Hey, my luck can't get any worse.
I don't like the word luck, but battle for third. Josh gets it. Five to go. I think JD holds on. Let's see how he does this. So now you got that slick laying around the top. So middle really comes in pretty good here. You had all the heat races down there and on the top. So that line in between just kind of comes in, but it's all about keeping the when you're running the middle, really anywhere, but especially here. It's about getting past it. If these drivers watched my Eldora How to Drive video, they would know this, where you want to get past that kink and get. Cam does a really good job here, where he gets it and gets all the straightaway grip he can there. Not exit down here in the shit, all the way up here. And that's how you
Use
got to
as
run the
much
middle
lateral,
here.
yeah. Use as
Yep.
much lateral grip as you can get.
JD getting the shotgun. Well, how's this gonna affect him here? Because now he turned. He got the straightaway grip on the front straightaway. All right, he held it decently there. He gave himself a really shit entry into the angle, at least in the one and two there. That was making speed. That baby slider. Josh just not able to get the middle enough. He can run the cut down here too. There you go. I like keeping it higher. See if he can. Oh, top wants to. Well, he turned down really bad. He ran that coal line. Where he's just going to turn into the middle into the slick. So remember what I said. I always say build up as much momentum going into the last corner as you can. And entering in the slick, turning down, and staying in the slick. That ain't how you do it. That ain't how you do it to set up the last corner. JD, good job of covering. Tries to stick the bottom. Sticks it pretty well. If he would have. I mean, he was carrying less speed because he came off the bottom here, but I think if he just rang his normal middle like he did before, which even wasn't great, but if he stuck the bottom like he did, he might beat JD Galine here, but he just didn't give himself enough speed. Not much more you can say about that. All right, now we have our C-Main. They're back again. We'll go cockpit view with yours truly. So we're starting. We started fifth. Started fifth. Where we think line is. How are you feeling after watching the last B-Main?
I feel like the bottom's going to come in. I could make some work, some stuff work down there. So, I mean.
Well, don't miss it by a car length. Both times.
There's a lot of grip. No, there's a lot of grip.
It seemed like you kept a lot of speed, yeah. Okay, Cole comes
in. He comes there. I kind of missed it on entry there, but then I'm able to get a good run here.
Go back far, Chase. See, see what's
there's a lot of grip off a four, which is kind of new.
Yeah, on the cut down. Oh, okay. So, see, I disconnected from the server, so I didn't see any of this heat race or B main. I mean, he's up. He's halfway up to you. He doesn't really have anywhere to go without completely slamming the brakes.
Look at the arc to the corner he's going at, though.
Yeah.
I mean, that's just,
yeah.
It's.
Where if you don't slide up all the way, there's going to be contact. But I get it. You're racing. You're trying to hold him to the bottom. Lewis goes for some rides, collects a lot of others. And he's trying, like I said, he'd have to slam the brakes to avoid you. Okay, now the two up front, they end up getting into it because you two end up racing for a transfer spot. Throws a slider, some coals under you, yep. Nice. I like the little cut down on that end. That cut down also looks good in three and four. Like a little middle to bottom. You see Batista goes for the lead. We're just gonna hop up front real quick. Oh, okay, so here. Because I think they crashed next lap, so. This was a prelude. Alright. Whose fault is this? Who do you think?
Kinda hard to tell. I think Batista's going straight, and whoever it is on his inside kind of slides through the slick.
Yeah, his angle to go up to hit the middle in the corner was worse. He has to make like an 85 degree angle to get it.
He kind of does the Scandinavian flick into the corner.
That's essentially what Zane Scott did in your heat race, I think. Where he just enters straight and then turns it in instead of, arcing it smoothly like Batista's doing.
I just drove straight through him.
Yeah, and then, so it takes him out. I don't know, if you're Batista there, everyone thinks the top is gone, so, like, I don't know. As a driver in my head, when, like, I'm like, alright, that lane's not gone, that's gonna, you kind of deduct what line they're going to run. So you're like, all right, top is gone, so that's the highest part of the racetrack. I have to give that guy room for that. So I'm either running the, a baby slider like JD was doing last race, or trying to stick to bottom.
At the same time,
But I'm not.
Batista's entering on the moisture where he thinks that, okay, Job's on my inside. He's not going to try and take this moisture that he knows I'm going to hit.
Exactly. He was just up by the wall. It's not like he did nothing, showed he was committed to the high side, and just goes in there. Unfortunately, it's
And
doored here.
it, I mean, a little bit of net code, they might have been able to drive away from it. But, you know. How did I pull away from Cole here? I don't really remember.
I'll go back and look, but I'm looking at, this was the B main, right? They didn't give an
Right.
incident point for that. So they didn't give a 4x at all to Job. So big crossover to him.
So as soon
Oh, you
as
see
yes,
that.
as soon as
If
Cole
you
threw the
want a
slider in
lifted
three,
there.
as soon as Cole threw the slider in 3 and 4, I kind of knew that I was going to be able to pull away from him.
There you go. Like an 8-3-3 to see, and then Cole tried to run that top and lost it all. Turning down a little too much here, but makes it work. Was faster. Again, just sliding in to the run the middle. Well, I guess he was coming from that line. Now you two in front are running cut down. There's
Yeah,
three to
I'm
go.
thinking about one. I couldn't figure out 1 and 2 exactly how I liked. I think it was kind of hurting me.
See there, he widened out. I like how he widened out his cut down this time. Remember I said he cut down a little too hard this time? This time he came in higher, cut down straighter.
Right.
Yeah, it's like, well, I mean, you kept trying to run that cut down when the last lap, the last race, I guess you could say, there was that grip that they could get out above that slick. And either that went away or no one's trying it this one. You guys are trying to run the cut down from the middle.
And here, I mean, I'm just kind of maintaining. I know
We're
that
two
I don't
laps to
have to
go.
change too
Like a
much.
9-2 is one. He's finding the bottom a little. He's searching around. I like that. There he didn't enter wide again. Alright, sticking bottom, trying to set himself up for a slider. And then wham! You! Let's
Out of the series, my God. Oh no, turn that off. Turn it off. Did you hear it?
At
Because
least
I
don't
didn't hear it on you. I can't
let
hear
the
anything in
race
your stream.
let him run the race after
Turn
that.
it
That
off.
was
I don't
terrible.
even know what I said.
You can? Oh.
I can't hear it on
You
Discord or
said,
something.
get this guy out of the series. All right. All right.
Might have been seeing red.
You and me, we normally see eye to eye on a lot of things. Most things. Like, if I was
I don't
ever to,
like
like.
where this is going.
I've rung us. Anytime we talk about how a league should be ran or how a track or the game, we normally agree on things, you know?
Racing lines, racing deals, right?
Yes, yes,
Don't like how
yes.
you're setting me up still.
What? All right. Regardless, he was going to hit you. I know there's net code. Regardless, he's going to hit you. Why don't we cover right here? You don't even have to run a slider, because I know Job's there, so you can't run a slider. But if we can stick bottom down there.
I don't know. I thought, I know I'm far enough away. There's no way. Like, this is the pro series, right? We have respect for each other. We're gonna race, how pros should race. In my head, there's no way. I'm thinking there's no way he's gonna try and come from as far back as he is. I'm running a cut down. He's running the bottom. I have more speed in the corner. He's on his back foot. I'm thinking there's absolutely no way he's gonna go for it. Was I wrong? Yes.
I'm a big
Like I said,
proponent. I'm a
it's a pro series. I feel like should have had more respect for each other and the broadcast and everybody watching. Kind of that was kind of a, I don't know. I feel like it's embarrassing to watch that. Not on my part, but I should have blocked, yeah, but it's, I'll take blame for having faith in somebody that, to race clean and to do the right thing. So
Agree with
No,
you there.
that's
Like
the
you
way
said,
I look at it.
if this was, if this was a chili bowl, B main, and somebody made that move, they'd be praised for it, depending on the driver. But like if it was like Timez and he made that move, and maybe not destroyed the guy like what happened, but like, just nudged him up the track from that far back, people would love it. And I get it, it's Pro Series, it's the B main and the transfer spot, it's worth like 30 points or whatever. But like you said, you expect that kind of respect from people. Now, if we look at Cole's race, he was racing for a transfer spot in the heat race, got doored up the track by Sheeble. You're a teammate of that. We know the hate that goes
So I'm
around
gonna stop you
towards.
right there.
Okay, go on, go
I love when people say, "Well, Sheeble wrecked him
on.
earlier," so that is the stupidest thing
Typical
I've ever heard of.
speed
That
lab!
is
Orange man
absolutely
bad! Fucking tricycle brain
I
people,
don't
yeah.
know how, like, regardless of being on the same team, how can you be like, "Oh, well, his teammate did it earlier." Like, I didn't do it. Like, I just don't, I would never get wrecked by somebody's teammate and then think, "Oh, I'm gonna wreck his teammate to get back at him." That is the stupidest thing I've ever heard.
And even out of all the like dumb wrecks that you might see a speed lab drive like ever in the past do, how many are actually from you, from as an individual, as a driver?
Don't ask
No,
Tyler Shell. That's the only one I have that comes to mind, and that one, I took blame for that one.
So once again,
So
we.
for mine, for with see, I was actually thinking about this too, because which me and Shell, right? That was just a bad move on my part. That was
Talk
race.
about the specific talk about the
I was trying.
specifics for the people who don't know.
It was a few laps into a lockdown heat race or hooked up heat race. In last year's Pro Series, I went to throw a slider on Shell. Didn't throw it in as deep and carry as much speed to get ahead of him as I thought, and I went right rear to left rear.
Was
No net
Volusia,
code.
right?
Right Evolution 3 and 4. No net code. It wasn't come to the checkered. I don't even remember if it was in for the last transfer spot, but I think we were fighting in the tr we were in a transfer, and it was just a bad move on my part. I was thinking that, it was because I was racing hard, right? It wasn't, "I'm gonna wreck him to get ahead of him," where I feel like that's all this move was right here. This is a move out of desperation, where, I mean, mine might have been a little bit, but it was more just trying to get ahead of the person in front of me rather than trying to end his night. I feel like I didn't explain that as well as I would have liked, but.
No, there was no intent, bad intentions to yours. Where his might have not had bad intentions. Like he knew there had to be contact. He knew, this was last
He knew
lap,
he had
last
to hit
corner.
me to clear. He
He,
knew he wasn't
yeah.
going to clear me. I honestly thought I was able to clear Shell. It was bad judgment on my part. His part was, I don't know what's opposite of
All right, can we at
bad
least do,
judgment.
because I'm a big propo like I am no Cole Newhoffen fan. Most people know my past with him. Cole has improved since as a driver, but he is still in times of
I hate to say after this, I feel like he has been quicker this Pro Series. It hurts me to say that after this week, but he has been quicker. And
Shocking.
it's just an example of somebody who doesn't know what to do with that speed.
Was Kinzer holding him back? Oh. Yeah, because like I said, I think he's one of the few that made every single feature. He is in points. He is in ninth. And I'm pretty sure nobody's seen that coming. If we look at my race predictions or anyone else's, they can have him up there. Like I said, but just with everything that added up, I mean, yeah, he already fucking doored you once this race too. Which also should have gave you another sign of I better fucking cover this guy because he's already shown he's willing to drive through me.
It's just my good
A
nature
teammate
believing
drove through
people.
him all the way. But like I said, on this channel, I'm a big proponent of taking responsibility. And like you said, yes, you should have covered. Now in the future, we're gonna learn from it, I hope, and we're gonna cover. We're not gonna, blame Cole 100% on this. Cole, I'm not defending him at all. He, like I said, he still drives like a piece of shit like this. He made the series look like trash doing it, which, like you said, is something you don't expect to see in a, like I said, a pro series race. Now, with the way the incident system is set up, Cole was not suspended for this. He did go on to make the race, and he's gonna get the race next week because he didn't get over the threshold of 12 X's. He's on 12. He went on to finish.
Dead last because he ran out of fuel. Really made the most of it.
Did he really?
Yes. Ran out of fuel.
Oh,
Yeah,
what
but
a fucking
fine.
goofball.
So.
But it also, like I said, so he may have not, people were like, he should have been parked. Well, likely he's gonna end up missing a race in the future because he gets another 4X. Maybe he just is clean, but the rest of the way. But
Or
also, he
maybe a
still has to.
report from a certain somebody makes it a more severe impact. But we'll
Other,
let the
well,
stewards
he
decide that.
still has to race against you for 6 more weeks. Now, are you gonna, I think you're on like 0X for the series. And just given the point structure, you're not gonna give him room all the time, but if there was ever, if you don't have the absolute most easiest pass, aren't you gonna make it tougher on him?
I'm pleading the fifth on this one because it
Okay,
will be used against me.
I get that, but I just think like people in the moment are very mad that nothing is happening immediately, but I feel like what goes
Right.
around is gonna end up coming around, And I'm not saying you're gonna go out there and straight line him or anything, nor should you, but like just for everyone, saying why this is why the series is broken because this and this and this, we'll see. Maybe I'm
If
eating my words.
he's gonna race like that and get away, I'm gonna say he got away with it. He got a 6X in the incident report, which is nothing. He gets to race next week. He got to race this week. He got the points for the feature. He got to race in the feature. If we're gonna be able to get away with certain things and it's up to us, that I'll take a six. I'm not saying I'm going to, but if we're able to get away with that kind of stuff, then I'll use the rule book to its full advantage. If I'll I can you know I mean I'll, am I gonna do it? Probably not. Am I gonna
Okay.
wreck somebody for a transfer spot on the white flag? Probably not. But I would like
Do
to say that I'm gonna
you
use the
think if
rule book
that's
to its
John
full advantage.
Batista, do you think that if that's John Batista in your position in that, does he throw that slider?
Why? Because it's not a speed lab car?
Perhaps.
I don't know, honestly. Like I said, I hope he's not holding a grudge over something because of Dylan did. That's, like I said, that's, I think, the stupidest thing ever. Yeah, I don't know. That's a good
Like I
question, though.
said, I'm not gonna act like I don't, like I said, use the rules we're given to our full advantage because I did that. The first race, I car hide Harvey for a transfer spot on the last heat, and this wasn't destroying them. This was just car hiding them at the line to make sure I finish ahead of them, and I did it to John Batista at Lima Land, knowing that I would get those incidents. But in the heat of battle of just wanting to get that transfer spot, starting spots for the feature, plus not having to run a B main because the dangers of running a B main. I said I was definitely willing to just do what I had to do and accept the consequences. Like I said, for you, and also those weren't in B. Like if it was a B main situation, especially, but it was just heat races when I did it, so they started front row of B
Him out
mains.
of the series,
But
my
I
God.
knew I
So,
would I accepted. I knew I would get a 4X, well 6X for each of them because they were in transfer spots.
yeah, that's not my driving style to do what he did. Even if he's gonna get away with it, I'm not gonna. I'm like I said, chances are I'm more than likely not gonna do it because that's not my style. But I don't know. I'd rather just see a change in the rules or at least enforcing of something that doesn't allow other people to do that because
Well,
it's
what?
like
This
I
is what I
said.
always say. This is when people want to talk about a problem, what is the solution to it then?
I mean, I know they say no live admins, but like, I don't know. My opinion, yoink him out of that race. I mean, that was terrible. It's not gonna put me in, but he shouldn't get to run the feature for that, in my opinion.
No,
But
and he wouldn't if he doesn't complete a lap. He doesn't get points. But what line did he? Because now I would look at past incidents that's happened in a B main,
so
and say, well, should
and
that guy have gotten booted?
well since
Just playing devil's
there's no live
advocate.
admin, the since the correct way to do it, I think, there's no live admins would be. He took my chance of a main event away, right, for this week.
Mm-hmm.
Take his away for next week. Don't even let him run. Can't show up. Week off. Lose the points for that race, just like he made me lose the points for that one. I mean, if it was a more clear slider and he had more of a chance and it was like more of a racing deal, then have at it. But there was absolutely no intent.
There was just a complete Hail Mary.
And making it.
Yeah.
Right. Hail Mary tucked the shoulder, sent me out of the ballpark.
All right. Well, guys got some warm-up on track. Obviously, it's Eldora. It's going to be top dominant, but it's just, I feel like all sunset tonight Eldoras, or maybe just all night Eldoras, they're just so, the crossover line is so easy. So it's, you know, like I was spot and braiding in this race, and I just know how he felt the whole time, because I knew any time you threw a slider, you're never going to clear a guy on the bottom fully. You're never going to drive around anyone in the middle. You have to throw a slider to pass and hope it sticks. But when the crossover line's as fast as it was in this race, you just feel hopeless because you know every time that they're able to cross over. So all you can pretty much do is just try to shorten up your sliders more and more until you make them lift, essentially.
Can we praise Bergeron for lifting there? Because he could have been like many other people and just said, nope, I'm not lifting, and drive through him, and it ends his race and the other car's race. But he just, I mean, that's why he's up front of these races, is because he sees that stuff. And it's like, if you take the split second to lift and to keep racing rather than just driving through somebody and wrecking both, it makes your whole night completely different.
I'll say this here too.
In the front of the pack, I think you can get away with that. But I mean, in the back, you know, in the heat races and stuff.
In the back, if you lift, some other monkey's going to come through.
Somebody's going to plow
through.
Not
lift,
right?
Yeah.
But so does that mean you still don't lift, or what do you do? I don't know, because I tend to lift just because that's what I do.
Mm-hmm. Another thing I'll say, and that I felt like I used to have a bad habit of this. Like, so here, you know, he gets a better run out of two. Kendall kind of falls off the cushion, so Kendall has to slide this up, so he knows he's going to have a bigger run. If that was me, I'm cutting down the track, and usually, whether I know who is where or not, now Cooper, is this Cooper? Yeah, Cooper all the way on the bottom, he's got room below Descharmier, but he not only lifted, he lifted and stayed in line.
Right, because I think he didn't know where Ducharme was at.
Possibly, yes, exactly. I know certain instances, I don't know specific ones, where I would cut down not knowing a car was there. Or even, you know, maybe he thought Ducharme was sliding up behind him. Maybe Cooper could have been sliding up to the middle.
Right.
And he just lifts and stays in line, which you especially don't see that. Yeah. Where, like I said, you'll see the guy cut down and then wreck someone else, which I know myself have done that before, too. Where he actually just lifted and stayed in line. Yeah, it was pretty much all top. Just Cooper making the bottom work early when he could, when it was there.
Pretty impressive season for him so far.
Like I said, he got past his worst round, which I assume is going to be February. I said, okay, he got a little bit lucky making the feature, but he still ended up finishing eighth there. And now another track, you know, where it's not really his thing, where it's all around the top mainly. And he comes home in, I think, fifth. So he is now, it's no longer a fluke. You know, you could have said that after week one, and you said I would say Knoxville is his best track. So you expect him to get a top five there, maybe, keeping the momentum going. But
six, right?
He's fifth
at Knoxville.
Here. Yeah, certainly he's still third and fourth in points behind Tim. Yeah. So Tim 255, he's 253, and then it's down to 240 to Kendall. It seems like Nick Cooper of old, I guess I'm ready to say, is back and a contender for sure. It's no longer just
probably looking
a
few cars
fluke.
Back here.
Like some people are trying to run, just stick that lane down. Not a bad choice, but you're just not going to get drive off the corners. Let's see what Cole's doing here. Tight squeeze there.
Looks like Marin checked up a little bit. Pretty smart there, knowing he's the middle car.
Yeah.
middle car has more information than both inside and outside car. Inside car doesn't know there's a car on the outside of the car outside of him. Inside car, same thing on the or the backwards. So I feel like if I'm ever three wide, car in the middle is responsible because he's the only one that can see both cars.
Yeah.
Good play by him.
This one, let's check out the lap before. This was the one and only wreck of the race. Okay. So Colton was kind of cutting down. Because someone said Colton fell off the cushion, and I didn't think so. I thought he was just cutting down. And, yeah, as we looked that way, and Hardy was just coming up. Yeah, maybe more, a little more than he was expecting, but he ran cut down the lane before, the lap before. Right. And Hardy's line. Like I said, it's just one of those instances where it's that's not the best line choice. Like, if I was Hardy and you're coming in here, I would just try to stick the, like, a lane up all the way around. Instead, he drives again deep. And, I mean, there is grip up here. Like I said, he saw Colton run it the last lap, too, the cutdown. So, just a race and deal, but I'm just seeing what both guys could do differently. Hardy could just ran the middle all the way around, and if Colton knew Hardy was there, I'm sure he would have just stuck the top all the way around if he could, but... Oh, here we have. Here we have a bit of a stack up on the restart. Contact there, a little wheel by Cole. Hardy gets inside wall. God, that's always just a killer. Hitting that wall out of two, and then no, you're just kind of spinning tire waiting for grip, and it just seems like...
Picks the front up and just goes across the whole track.
Yeah, and it's like, all right, one or two guys might be by me, and then you see the first two, then the next two, and then the next guy on your inside, and it's like, motherfucking son of a bitch, you know? That's how I felt when we just ran the DRT race.
Turkey Nationals?
No, the DRT race. Were you went in the bottom, I went in the bottom, we got into each other out of two. I didn't really lift for him.
I yelled at you for not lifting.
You missed the bottom! But yeah, then we were both, we were just both sitting ducks on the straightaway, and I was like, fuck, here comes everybody, you gotta let them by, and it's, but, like, that's what happened, that's the risk you run, you just can't carry any sort of speed out of the corners on the bottom or middle here, so when you do run the bottom or middle, when you fuck it up, it just, it's so bad. So here we start. There's great racing behind this, too, so I'm going to have to flip back on. We don't want to watch these three go nose to tail all the time. But good cut down by Hagen. Alex kind of is forced to follow it. But here's what I mean, where it's just, all right, you throw a slider in three
right
and four,
there,
you
another,
can be perfect.
Another smart move by Bergeron. He knows that Hayden's throwing the slider. Hayden can clear it. Mm-hmm. Bergeron can't, so he doesn't throw a full slider. He kind of does a cheater.
Yeah.
Cheater slider.
Yep, to get himself back up to the top. But yeah, it just shows where that
pounce whenever these guys start racing.
That little cut down was just so fast in 3 and 4, and then, like I always say, that's really the better passing point, because if you slide someone 1 and 2, especially at night when the cushion's really rough, if you throw it an inch too far, that's gonna make your rear end snap around out of two. And then, like, because there's more bank in here, the cut down is used generally easier. Here he just throws it because he's on his tail. And I was so worried because,
right,
like, all the net code that has happened, I was like, don't get your bumpers, you know, hooked or anything. There, Tim was just able to clear him enough. Hagen does a good thing just running the slider. Gets a little more crossed up than he'd like to.
He probably lost a little bit turning down there, but he gained so much speed on that straightaway
and then
moisture.
And then he makes that straightaway moisture all the way into the corner here. When
a lot
most
of the
people
time,
would
people
start
don't clear
beating.
Sliders. Is because they're in the slick and they don't get launched
mm-hmm.
out in front
they're,
of this guy.
They're up here.
Right,
they're going straight.
Yeah. What he does right here, he launches himself through the corner so that he can clear him and try and carry speed at the same time.
Yep.
Or a lot of people will just drive it in straight through the slick and end up hitting them or clearing them, but then
they end up breaking
down,
their car loose even before they slide up to the lane that they're trying to take away.
Right. And that helps you carry more exit speed as well, but just because you have so much speed through the corner.
So let's go back here. There's a lot of it. So Austin trying to bottom here. Got James, Shell, Cooper, Cam.
I know James had right rear damage after the start. I think Semmelman hit his right rear and it was laying hard on the right side.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
he was
got
still
stuck
good.
Bad on that start. See the different lines. James kind of cheating it, coming up, and then staying there where, oh, as opposed to someone staying up all the way around.
Right there, James throws a short slider. If he goes all the way down the bottom there, he loses so much off the corner,
yep,
but
he,
see,
he
keeps
his exit.
Even with them by shortening up his slider so much.
Yep. Cooper
that's
runs a cut
Adam,
down and
that's the
Adam
short slider.
Cam trying to just stick the middle, but it's not much. But all in all, like, no one wrecked from out of this, and they're doing this the whole last 10 laps
right.
Also. So it was good driving by all of these drivers.
Those are probably all the top 8 guys
yeah.
in points too. I don't know where
Cam every
is
single
exactly,
one of these guys are at, they're at least in the top 15 in points. And you see the reason why. Everyone knows
know
where each other is.
And they know when to take
yep.
it.
Yep. Exactly. And only got this guy creeping in. but yeah, just the whole race, these guys were. Yeah, I mean, that's Eldora. That's all you can really do. And hope you get clear and then are able to try to run away from someone. Coop goes back to the bottom. I don't know he's that close to Kendall, but top three just checked out into another zip code. I will show the lap before. Oh, maybe Hagen. I was just going to show where Hagen. This kind of cost him the race. Where he cuts down here, goes to throw a slagger on Tim, knows he's not gonna clear it, and then he backs out of it so much. Easy tub by Alex.
Didn't
yeah.
commit to either.
Yep. And then he was gone.
Fell out of the draft.
Yep. You throw him. Yep. You lose your rhythm. Then you're trying to catch back up, and it's just that's just Eldora, you know. When once you lose it, it's so hard to get it back, and especially when you're trying to, you know, run another driver down. Good job by Alex here, you know, instead of steering the car back up. Once you fuck up and hit the wall like this and you're coming down, don't steer it back up because you're going to lose so much speed on entry. Just use it, make up what you can, throw the short slider, get yourself back up to the top. Another good move by Cam there, good job of Tyler lifting. These guys are just duking it out the whole race, just really good keeping tabs on where every guy was, you know.
Cole trying to do something different consistently, that way if somebody bunches up he's not in it.
Yep.
And he's got to run.
Yep, that's a huge thing. That's where I always say don't follow people in the corners, especially if it's three cars like that, because you know you can keep you're just cutting down like he is. It's safe on exit and then middle, so if someone runs into a wall he's cutting down and he's under him. And then also he's not losing anything because he's cutting out. He's giving himself the most momentum for when a door opens up. We're cutting down the track all the time like that, and it's safe. So it's good lines by him. Cooper's still running the bottom up there. He's almost getting inside of Kendall. Kendall running a big cut down. He's really just slowing down, keeping it straight, and then
keeping that left side in the moisture is huge. Even though you're cranked left, if you keep the left sides in the moisture, that's the only thing you could do to run the bottom.
All right, three to go. Here we start seeing the battles for the lead. I think Tim hit the wall. That allowed Alex to get under him and start throwing this slider.
Oh,
and
there's
you
the
see,
net code.
You see this net code here. But I can't think of the specific race.
See Tim's left rear come off the ground, too?
Yep. Where I did that, it wasn't net code, but, like, I didn't. I wasn't going to slide him. Like, I was just going to run a lane down. But it really messed up their entry enough where they kind of got in the wall. I don't remember it. I did that, and then as soon as it was right here, like I said, I was watching from Megan. I said the race is over. I said Tim's gonna throw a slider, Alex is gonna cross over and be gone, and that's what happened. Tim pretty much threw it as close to Alex's nose as he could. But Alex saw it coming, reading him like a dime, and just started the crossover early. Just got down enough. Then on last lap, I just kept telling him, hey, just build the mow, just build the mow. I think Tim gets the wall. I got two here. And then gets neck covered again down here. I was in a very similar spot. It
Wow.
was in the, what the fuck was it? It was the second. It was a race Hagen won. It was an Australian World Series race, but like I ran a big cut down the last corner to get momentum, and then Tim kind of came down the block late, and then instead he didn't spin out. I think because there was no net code, so like our cars actually came together, and then he spun out, and they gave me an EOL for it. But it's almost like because of the net code here, it just pushed him up the track. It didn't wreck him, which was lucky for Tim because he still got third at least. But I mean, I got fucking DQ'd from that race, but it was just. That exact scenario, it was like that one. Didn't have a huge overachiever of the week. Like everyone pretty much finished top 10 that should have. Like I said, all those guys we said were all up there in points. So it was Schiebel's first feature race, but also Gregory Lamy's, and I think he qualified in like 8th place. So I guess we'll give our overachiever of the week to Gregory Lamy. Yeah, any last insight you'd like to give about Eldora or how this racing went or
I don't know. I mean, you watch the top eight there, and you just see how far a little bit goes. I mean, give a little bit and take a little bit when you can, and then you surprisingly have good racing. You get the right set of guys. I mean, honestly, any racetrack could be good. And yeah, that's all I got.
And I'll throw it in. So you see how, so out of maybe those six guys, I guess Kendall wasn't really in it, but you had James and you had Cole and you had Tyler and like all those people, like everyone gives bitches about Slick and Speed Lab and whatnot, but there you just saw 30 lap. I'm not saying, well, this is the instance that, but I'm saying when you get the best drivers with the best drivers, it all kind of culminates into a good race where drivers, maybe like Ducharme or like Cole Habery, not really James because he doesn't get in much stuff, but when you see them make the mistakes that they do in certain instances, and then people use that to like typical speed lab, when that's usually against drivers that aren't really at that level, because like I said, just like Cole running that cut down line he did against Schiebel in his heat race, where it's because that driver isn't doing the right thing that they should have. That's why the contact was made with it happened to be a speed lab car. But where every driver, doesn't matter what team, when they all do the right thing, you get the racing that you had between them. And so it's just really just the skill gap and people not running the right lines. That, I mean, it's really afterwards it's easy to look at and say what was the right line, what was the wrong line, but yeah, it's just
Tom is tired.
yeah, we're tired,
Yeah, I mean,
you know what I mean?
the best drivers against the mediocre drivers, for lack of better words. I mean, the best drivers think, oh, this is the logical thing to do. This is what he's gonna do.
And the mediocre driver
And
won't always do that.
exactly. And there is a lot of misconception on the best drivers expecting people to do the right or wrong thing. And you can't never expect what people are gonna do. You have to just watch what they are doing and see what they're gonna do. That's always my biggest thing is I've been slid and hit tons of times. And somebody's like, oh, I didn't expect you to do that. It's like, well, you shouldn't expect me to do anything but what I'm doing. I mean, I'm gonna run the bottom. If I'm out in front of you, I'm gonna try the bottom. Don't just drive through me when you're gonna throw a slider, Wait till I'm not gonna go down there to block it before you slow, before you throw it. I mean, you can't just expect people to do anything because it's gambling is all it's all it comes down to.
And that's why I always, I try to tell people, expect the worst scenario from that driver too, almost. Expect like especially if it's in a random official, but even if it's someone, like a mediocre driver you might know in a league, still always, expect the unexpected type thing.
Yeah, because that, like I said, that's most of the time I make contact with people when I assume they're going to do something. And then, like you said, you can never assume because that's gambling. I like how you said that. Enough circle jerking here. This is Adam Elby. Thank you for coming on. You quickly want to thank anybody, you know, who you're running for. Thank your sponsors, parents, anything.
Gotta thank the Speed Lab guys. You know, they dial me in with setups and all that stuff.
Boo!
So that way, listen, so that way I don't have to practice at all, and I could just show up and try my best. And, why put in hours and hours and hours of practice if something unexpected is just going to happen and you're going to get wrecked?
Get
wrecked
by a monkey. Yeah. this is why nobody practices until Mondays at all. That's
all right.
It's just hilarious how that works in dirt.
Right. But, man, thank you for having me on. Hope it wasn't too bad. You know, I let you be on our short-lived podcast as a host. So if Hylomania wants me back, then I'll come back. If not, I don't really care, dude. I just get on here and have fun, right?
Right.
So that's why we play MX Bikes now.
Yeah. All right. Thank you guys for watching. Leave a like if you liked or learned anything. Enjoyed, and always peace the fuck out. Got the incident thingy after this. See ya.